I fixed my hair. There you go. So yeah, while we're waiting, I just went for this little walk. This town is gorgeous. Look, they have this beautiful marina and just all this stuff behind me. So cool.
Go ahead on the outside, lane yep. Zero, over there by the blue shack.
Lane zero. Okay, and now we're waiting for 1 hour.
So I still have 1 hour to get on the ferry. I mean, the ferry's not even here. And yeah, this is how it looks like. All the cars are lined up. The ticket was around $160 for 5 hours ferry ride. Not cheap, but in Alaska, all the ferries are super expensive. So, and it saves me like a 1 day of riding. I'll be just seeing the glaciers and all. So it'll be a good trip. That's why I'm doing it.
There's some Harley riders behind me. Where's your helmets? Where's your helmets? Good. All right. So we're going after this camper. No worries.
They're adjusting the ramp.
Okay. They're adjusting the ramp. Thank you. To the right. To the right. Thank you. In the middle. To the left. Okay, she's all strapped up. Now we're gonna go upstairs. Is here. Fix my hair. And we're off. We have a first glacier here on the left, I'll show you. Halfway there, 2.5 hours I think to go. I can't believe, I mean it is quite
cloudy, but no wind. It's actually quite pleasant temperature. We're nearly there. Smaller than I thought.
Yeah, it's a little bigger once you kind of get in there.
We made it. We didn't die. So we had a bit of a drama. The hotel I arrived from the ferry didn't get my booking. I booked it online and didn't go through. So anyway, after 1 hour, sorting out, everything is booked out in town except for airport man camp. So this is the scenario. These are the rooms. It's pretty much for workers in the area, and I just feel like I'm back to Pilbara in Australia, you know, like on the mine site. Similar scenario. All right, let's find our room. That's us, Chili. Right, so this is the scenario. This is not bad at all for a workers camp. There you go. A few patches on the wall, but that's all right. Good morning. How's my hair? My night at the man camp was excellent. My room was just somewhere there. It was very good. I slept like a rock. I was very tired. Right, so my plan for today is we're gonna explore Valdez, because apparently this town is like one of the best highlights of Alaska, just due to its location. I mean, look at this. I mean, even here it's so stunning. So yeah, we're gonna go to town, see what's there. Maybe we'll stay around the area for another day. I don't know, we'll see. I haven't figured it out yet. We just go with the flow as always. There's a glacier.
Head west on Airport Road toward Hangar Way.
Shush. Yeah, so there's a glacier. So, what a location, hey? Wow. Well, this small harbor. There you go. Lots of boats. Radio Shack. Oh, Chili, I think we should take a picture here. What do you reckon? This is nice. Maybe not so nice. All right, hold on, fix my hair. Healthy. I can now officially welcome you to Valdez. What a beautiful town, city that is. The location is just incredible. And look at this marina and the color of the water, sort of like a glacier color. And we have just a perfect day. Wow, you have to see this. I show you what are we dealing here, what sort of scenario is going on here. Alaskan hatchery. This is how they grow salmon. So basically, from what I understand, they grow salmon up the river and then they release it to the ocean. And then when the salmon is bigger, of course they want to come back to, you know, lay eggs and all, where they were born. And because they were born up the river, they have this, like, now they have like a little step, and then they try to jump through that step, but they can't. And that's how they regulate them, because they know salmon will always come back, so they wait until they're a little bit bigger. I think that's how it goes, roughly. But anyway, just have a look. This is just insane. Insane. I've never seen so much salmon in my life. I didn't even know how it looks like. Yeah, no. Ooh. Fish you welcome, fish you...